Happy New Year. Stick around. New Year once again. So, I am Davros and I am a Whovian, and today I am reviewing Doctor Who Resolution. So, given what I've just witnessed and what I'm about to talk about, there are going to be massive spoilers. So I'm going to warn you now that there are spoilers in this, so if you haven't watched it, you know, go and watch it, and then we'll come back here and then watch this review. So, Doctor Who Resolutions. So, after a series of no classic monsters returning, New Year's Day 2019, we finally get a classic monster returning, and it's everything I hoped for. The Daleks. Well, a Dalek at least. You know, and you know, basically it starts off as this story where these three warriors, you know, go to different corners of the earth and bury three pieces of this thing that we don't know about yet. And then in Sheffield, we get this Dalek dug up. Yeah, that's it. They find one piece of a Dalek, and it's the organic part. And then next thing, this Dalek attaches itself to a host, which is one of the archaeologists, Lynn, played by Charlotte Ritchie, who I know as Oregon from Fresh Meat. She's also been called the Midwife and another BBC sitcom, Siblings. Called The Midwife, not a sitcom. Yes, we finally get the 13th Doctor confronting a Dalek, and like Stephen Moffat said once, you're not the Doctor until you confront the Daleks, and now that that's happened, I feel fully satisfied. Oh yes, you know, and you know, Series 12 is not coming until 2020, so we've got a year before we see any more new Doctor Who, but now that you know, we finally got the Daleks in the new era, I can now, you know, I'm okay with this year break. You know, I'm okay with this full year hiatus. You know, I'm completely fine with it. Yeah, it's good. Yeah, so all my life I've lived in Sheffield, and turns out right underneath the, you know, the city hall, town hall, there's a bloody Dalek buried right beneath our feet. That's mental. First, you know, some nutter from outer space, Tim Shaw, bloody rampages around Sheffield. Then we get, like, massive spiders. And now, we have a Dalek. Right underneath Sheffield. That's bloody mental. The whole episode was mental, and I loved it. So, yeah, I love Jodie Whittaker in this. I always wanted to see her confront the Daleks. Now that she has confronted the Daleks, I'm happy now. I can, you know, I'm okay with this year break that's come, that's here now. Because, yeah. And even though we never saw the Dalek in its shell until like the final act of the episode, I was okay with it, because I thought as long as it's a Dalek and it's in the show, I was happy. And yeah, we got a Dalek in a homemade shell made of stainless Sheffield steel by the look of things, and it looked rubbish, but I didn't care. I didn't care how terrible the Dalek casing looked in this. I was just happy seeing the Daleks back. Well, a Dalek back in it. Yeah, I just loved it. It was amazing. It was brilliant. Excuse me. I'm so happy we got a Dalek at last with Jodie Whittaker's Doctor. She's long overdue. Her Doctor was and the Dalek were long overdue for an encounter, and I'm happy with that now that they've finally done it. That's what I liked about this episode. I like that we got the Daleks, and I liked that, you know, I love Jodie Whittaker in this, you know, and now with the TARDIS confronting a Dalek, she is the Doctor. I don't care, you know, what gender wise it is now, I'm a huge fan, and I love her. I love her as the Doctor. I don't care what people say, she is brilliant. I also love Bradley Walsh in this as usual. He's been a great companion. Yaz and Ryan were great in this. But like, you know, Yaz, she didn't really feel as important in this episode. But, you know, I'd say she's earned her place in the TARDIS team. She just needs a bit more, like, more development, I think. Ryan reconnected with his father. You know, because he didn't come to his grand's funeral, and I was like, you know, and I'm thinking, his dad's actually come, which is mental. Well, yeah, it's a new year. I guess his dad wants to reconnect with his son, and that, and you know, Ryan did reconnect with his dad, and that. So I like that story bit in it. I also liked our two other actors in this. I don't know who the guy is, but I know the girl Charlotte Ritchie in it was controlled by a Dalek. Yeah, this Dalek, it was not like a regular Dalek. This Dalek was smart. It was one of the early Daleks to come to Earth. And it did. It came to Earth. You know, when the Doctor was making the analysis and she said, "This is the DNA of the deadliest species on Earth," I was going, "Come on, say it. Say it's a Dalek." And then when she said the Dalek, I was like, "Yes! You know, we finally have a Dalek." I know that's... I can't stop talking about it. It's that great. So, yeah. I enjoyed this story. Will I in the second viewing? Maybe? I don't know. I have to give it a second watch. But, yeah. I've enjoyed what I've seen. And it was a great way, in my opinion, a great way to kick off the new year. Now for my dislikes. I didn't like, you know, like, there was three pieces of this Dalek, and it was buried in three different pieces, parts of the Earth, and guarded by the descendants of the people. One of them didn't quite make his journey because he got killed on his way there, and then got buried under what will one day become Sheffield. I don't like how they showed us that, you know, the people guarding the other two pieces, and then it's showing us what's happening. I didn't like how they didn't pick up on that. No, I didn't. I didn't like how they didn't pick up on that, but... excuse me. I'm still getting over a cold. I just thought... Maybe they're leaving it open, but you know, it's going to be one hell of a wait, because like I said, it's on hiatus now till 2020. Let's hope that Doctor Who will return in January or February 2020, because, you know, I just think that they should do that. I mean, it's already in production, Series 12. It's already in the works. They started production in November, so they should be getting it underway. I don't know why they want a year break, maybe to do more episodes or something. I don't know, but I'm sure a year's wait is going to be worth it, because it does pay off, in my opinion. I vlogged a while ago on my other channel, one of my other channels, that a year break for me works because they get chance to develop stuff and everything and improve or what have you. Yeah, I just thought this was a bloody great episode and a great way, you know, to get over those, you know, post-Christmas January winter blues. But yeah, now we wait for series 12. The Doctor will return because, as the credits ended, it did say the Doctor will return, and that. So yes, yeah, I enjoyed this episode. I'm rambling now, so let's just get to my final thoughts and ratings. This was a good episode, a good special. You know, it's, yeah, it has somewhat made up for no Christmas special this year. Maybe this New Year special is a one-off and we'll get a Christmas special at Christmas, or maybe this is going to be a new thing now, New Year specials instead. I don't know, but let's just say, you know, let's just hope we get another special around the holidays again, Christmas or New Year. Anyway, this was a great episode. I enjoyed it. It was a fun one. I was so happy to see the Daleks, or a Dalek, finally in it. So with all that being said, do you know what? The mood I'm in right now, I'm going to give this 5 out of 5. 5 out of 5 for Doctor Who Resolutions. And I shall be getting the Series 11 box set, which is out on the 14th of this month, January. And I think Resolutions might be coming out with that, or it might be coming out separately. I don't know, but all I know is I'm going to get all that, you know, to keep me busy. And also, yeah, I'll keep myself busy for the year with no new Who. There's so much more out there I can do throughout the year. Yeah, which I will explain in an update video that I also have scheduled. I've already filmed an update for that explaining my plans for this month and that. So anyway, yeah, let me know what you think down in the comments below. If you like this video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already and to hit that notification bell. All of my social media links are down below in the description. So, until next time, run for your life.